forgiving, and praying for those who persecute us. Hello, and welcome to the Manna to Live By. One day at a time. 5-Minute Devotionals. Today is September 10th. Today's reading is from Matthew, chapter 5 and verse 44. Pray for those who spitefully use you and persecute you. Sometimes, an illustration is the best commentary on a verse. Captain Mitsuo Fuchida was the Japanese pilot who directed the attack on Pearl Harbor on December 7, 1941. He sent back the message, "Torah, Torah, Torah," indicating the complete success of his mission. But World War II was not over. As the conflict raged on, the tide of battle turned, until finally, the United States was victorious. During the war, the Japanese executed an elderly missionary couple in the Philippines. When their daughter in the U.S. got the news, she decided to visit Japanese prisoners of war and share with them the good news of the gospel. When they asked her why she was so kind to them, she would reply, "Because of the prayer my parents prayed before they were killed." But that is all she would say. After the war, Mitsuo Fuchida was so bitter that he decided to bring the United States before an international tribunal to be tried for war atrocities. In an attempt to collect evidence, he interviewed Japanese prisoners of war. When he debriefed those who were held in the U.S., he was chagrined to hear, not of atrocities, but of the kindness shown by a Christian lady whose parents had been killed in the Philippines. The prisoners told how she supplied them with a book called The New Testament, and mentioned that her parents had prayed some unknown prayer before they were executed. This was not exactly what Fuchida wanted to hear, but he made a mental note of it anyway. After hearing the story numerous times, he went out and bought a New Testament. When he read the Gospel of Matthew, his attention was arrested. He read through Mark, and his interest deepened. When he came to Luke 23:34, light flooded his soul. "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do." Instantly, he knew the prayer that the elderly missionary couple had prayed before they were killed. He no longer thought of the American woman or the Japanese prisoners of war, but of himself, a fierce enemy of Christ, whom God was prepared to forgive, in answer to the prayer of the crucified Savior. At that very moment, he sought and found forgiveness and eternal life by faith in Christ. Plans for the international tribunal were scrapped. Mitsuo Fuchida spent the rest of his life proclaiming the unsearchable riches of Christ in many countries.
Let's pray. Father, grant me the grace, I pray, to forgive those who persecute me or try to harm me, and thus follow the path kept for me by my Savior. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Forgiving and praying for those who persecute us.
Today's Manna, originally written by William MacDonald. Adapted and developed as Manna to Live By, 5-Minute Devotionals for You Too, by John Benjamin. Bengrace@gmail.com.